dying. And we love this life so much that even now, the sisters can't escape the wind. Even the sisters now, not all of them, because we have to be fair. Believe it or not, there's still sisters that genuinely fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And sisters that still want simple lives, halal living. There are still these women. But even the sisters now, what do they want? Who knows? I want an ex-bad boy, man. Look how poisonous. Poisonous. Or the beautiful women want the ex-bad boy. So this guy who's genuine, good kid, you know, he fears Allah, he's not very loud, goes to school, he's an educated man, he's trying to make a living, maybe simple life. Instead of giving our best women to him, who does he take? He takes the girl that nobody else wants. Look how, oh my soul. So the sister wants what? Alhamdulillah, he's repented. Just to be fair, because I've made this mistake, those that have genuinely repented, who are we? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I forgive all sins. But I feel from the sisters, they love it. They love a brother whose tattoo just happens to go past his sleeve. Why? And you can still see it, yeah? They love it. And yes, sister, while you might enjoy your Burberry bags, and you might enjoy your very, very nice car, and while you might enjoy the holidays here and there, but you don't know the other side of that coin, man. You don't know the sleepless nights. You don't know that when your kids come to you and tell you, where's daddy, man? You don't know when your husband gets knocked, he gets killed for something that you didn't know about. Then you got to raise these kids on your own for the rest of your life. Why? Because you wanted the bad boy, man. You don't know. Wallahi, my brothers, life was not meant to be easy. Understand this. Life wasn't meant to be easy. If life was going to be easy, then surely the Prophet of Allah would have had it easy in cruising, true? But he didn't have it easy, man. Sisters always told me, you know, I've heard this so many times. Brother, I wish I was married to the Prophet of Allah. Have you heard this? I wish I was married to one of the companions. I tell a sister, really? Do you know what it would have been like to be married to the Prophet of Allah? Your husband here, because he doesn't take you to restaurants, you complain. Your husband, because he doesn't take you to restaurants, you complain and you whinge and you whine. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, in the authentic hadith, she's speaking to her nephew Urwa. Listen to the words. Brothers and sisters, listen. She says, Wallahi ya Urwa. She's speaking to her nephew Urwa. She says, Wallahi, we used to see the full moon, then the full moon, then the full moon. Two complete months would go past, and not a single flame, yani no cooking and no boiling of any sort. She said not a single flame would be lit in any of the 9 houses of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Urwa says, he says, oh my auntie, how did you people live? She said what? She said, al-aswadan, the two black things, al-tamru wal-ma, dates and water, for 2 consecutive months. Which side of the fence are we on, my brothers?